Let's listen to the Beatles. I agree! Because today, all of you seem to be so sad. We are going to do happy songs. No, I'm not taking your suggestions anymore. We're all gonna feel depressed after watching Lucas's live stream. You're gonna feel terrible after watching my live stream. That's not how this is supposed to work. You're gonna feel good after watching my live stream. So here are the Beatles with Here Comes the Sun. Chill. I just said I'm not taking your suggestions. Because you all make me sad.
I say,
that was serious. I am serious. Why Lulu suddenly smiling? Because you are here. We are happy to see you today. Welcome, welcome back, and enjoy the sun.
Here comes the sun, and I say, it's alright.
Click for the follow. There you go, you found the follow button. Congratulations. Now you learn free English every single day. Every single day. Your topic today is listening practice. Thank you so much, Linda. You are so kind. Caucasians are funny. I don't think it has to do anything with race. Just don't be an asshole. You have to study. Good luck, Haya. Give me free lesson. Lucas, give me free lesson now. You say free lesson? Give me free lesson. Listen to the music, all right? That's the lesson. Enjoy the music. That's today's class. Listen to the music. Have you had dinner? Yes! Had some pork, had some chicken, had some fermented milk, aka yogurt. I like that one, Duda. Smile emoji with the Italian fingers. How can I join Discord? You can join it in our amazing link in the poll. What poll? This poll. You go to the link in the poll, you are in our Discord server. Just copy and paste. Copy and paste. Control C, Control V. I'm your student. What's up? I want to learn English. Good. But why I'm still boring? I don't know if you being boring has to do with learning English. Are you bored when learning English? Make it fun. Do the thing you like. Reading books, listening to music, whatever you enjoy, that's the way you can learn. Alright, we're gonna look at this song because that's what I gotta do, right? We're gonna look at the song, The Beatles, Here Comes the Sun. After this, we'll play a more modern song, all right? If you don't like it, just learn English. Just learn English with us. Why I can understand everything you're saying, but I don't, because I am just that good of a teacher. And you don't practice enough. You gotta open your mouth more. You can't hear the song clearly? I'm gonna help you out right now. Stop talking. Listen. Welcome, Cindy. Welcome back. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. It's kind of a weird thing to say, no? Here comes the sun. What do you mean, here comes the sun? When would somebody say, here comes the sun, guys? Who can tell me? When would somebody say, here comes the sun? Augustine, you are totally right. In the morning! sunrise, sunrise. Don't just say morning, say sunrise. Dawn. You could also say dawn, guys. I'll teach you a word. Dawn. D-A-W-N. Dawn is the same as sunrise. It's early in the morning when the light comes out. Dawn. Here comes the sun, and I say, it's all right. Sounds like he had a tough night. Sounds like he had a tough night. Something happened. Maybe the day before was a bad day. But the next day, the sun in the morning comes back and he says, I'm all right. I'm all right. Good. Little darling. I would not call someone a little darling. It's kind of a weird way of calling your girlfriend. Instead of baby or darling, you call her little darling. Is it like your daughter? That might work. If it's your daughter, little darling, then it's cute. All right. It's been a long, cold, lonely winter. There you go. It's a long, cold, lonely winter. Now we know what happened. It was a long winter, and one day in the beginning of spring, here comes the sun. I know if you live in Vietnam or Indonesia, you still don't know what this means, but there is winter in some places and there is summer. It is, the sun is not there 24/7. I know it's hard to imagine, but that's how the world works. Four seasons. It's been a long, cold, lonely winter. Not just a long winter, not just a cold winter or a lonely winter, a long, cold, lonely winter. He is really emphasizing he was alone. Stop suggesting songs. I'm not going to take your suggestion right now. Listening practice involves listening to what we're doing right now. Little darling, it feels like years since it's been here. It feels like years since it's been here. What's it's? Something has not been there for a long time. What is it's, guys? Since it's been here. Give me a lesson now. I'm giving you the lesson right now. Are you paying attention? Or are you just repeating the same thing to get attention? The smile, the snow, no, the sun, yes! Remember, the title of the song is Here Comes the Sun. It feels like years since it's been here. It's been a cold, long, lonely winter. We're missing the sun. Do you ever have that? Like these days in Wuhan, I want to come to Vietnam and Indonesia as fast as possible because there is no sun in Wuhan. Here comes the sun and I say, it's all right. It's all right, guys. It's all right. Do you think maybe he is not only talking literally, maybe he is also talking figuratively, figuratively, like in the idea that something long, something dark, something bad has been happening, and now there is a sparkle of hope, there is a sparkle of things getting better. Everything has been going down the whole time, and now something seems to turn the tide, change it around. I just thought about that. Maybe that's what's been going on. Sparkle of hope is a normal English saying. Turn the tide. turn the tide is changing direction. Turning the tide. The sun represents a new hope of things to come. Exactly. Little darling, the smiles returning to the faces. The smiles returning to the face. It's like we are listening to your sad music for an hour, and then Lucas finally plays a happy song, and the smiles are coming back. You are the winter. I'm the summer. I'm the sun. It feels like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun, and I say, you want to be the moon, guys? What do you want to be? You want to be the moon? Or you want to be a star? Too much, okay? Too much. Learn English first, then you can be a star. I want to be your wife, and I want you to calm down, all right, Lucas, or English teacher. Nice to meet you. Sun, 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 he comes. Lucas has a very high voice, if you didn't know that. Now you know. The sun is coming back, guys. Do you feel everything getting better? Do you feel the dark time being over? Do you feel the happiness inside growing with every breath? You're getting better just like your English. When it comes to English, it's like you've been learning grammar and it looks so difficult. Everything is going downwards, but here comes the sun. You're having a conversation and the talk with your friend goes so well. There it is. Here comes the sun again for English learning. I'm not answering your question, Linda, because I'm doing a class, if you didn't notice. Is moonshine a wine which is home-brewed? Yes. You look like Italians, not far from. What's your name? Lucas. Nice to meet you. Sun. You practice speaking every day? Good job. That is how you do it, all right? That's how you do it. And if you don't know why that is important, check Sunday's video. Coming Sunday, I'll tell you why speaking is so important. And tomorrow, I think. Are you a teacher full-time? Ah, live stream every day and give you videos every day. That's full-time, right? Simple song, but a nice song. This is the Beatles. Here comes the sun. Makes me feel good. Makes me feel relaxed. It's also a happy song, guys. You're looking for happy songs. I give you happy songs. You can join the Discord. You can add me, Learn with Lucas, on Discord. And I will add you. Turn it off. I'm sorry. 500 people on TikTok like this song, so... Play, 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 play. Hate is gonna hate, guys. Hate is gonna hate. Listen, Taylor Swift is always good to learn English. If you like her or not, a lot of her songs have idioms, have phrasal verbs, have sayings. Really good songs to learn English from. Grammar, not always perfect. but a lot of good idioms and native tones. Gotta be honest, I'm not a Taylor Swift fan in particular, guys. I don't listen to her song when I'm alone, but you can learn English from it. I just know the song, okay? I just know the song. I'm English anyway, fair enough, Paul, fair enough. Thank you for the follow, Alfredo. Welcome to learning English with us. I thought it's an English class. Welcome to Lucas's English classes, where no whiteboards, no me telling you you are wrong. Every Tuesday and Thursday, we learn with music. And today, we are learning with happy music. Today's subject is happy, because your songs make me feel depressed. Thanks so much, Shilin. Welcome back. Good to see you again. Appreciate your support. It's a long song. 3.5 minutes. Shake. Shake it. Trinity, thanks so much. You learn from me? Good! That's why I'm here. From Manchester, awesome. Have I been to Manchester? No, I've been to Newcastle. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I shake it off. Shake it off. My hair is escaping, guys. My hair is escaping. Shake it off. Shake it off. Do I really have to ask you if we are gonna learn English with this song? Quick poll. If you like the song, press the smile emoji. If you don't like the song, press the cry emoji. The more votes win, and that's the song we will look at. Tell me if you like the song or not. That's what you gotta do, guys. That's what you gotta do. It's all you have to do in this live stream. Swifties love this, and there are always Swifties in chat. Guys, I feel like we need a specific live stream for Swifties. We need a specific live stream for Arianators. We need a specific live stream for... I don't know how to call the other ones. Whatever you are, whenever you are, welcome to Learn English with us. Every Swiftie is welcome. Every Arianator is welcome. Every Metallica fan is also welcome. I do have YouTube, English with Lucas. Megan, welcome to join us. All right. Do you love Bob Marley? I do. I listen to Bob Marley in my free time too. Michael Jackson fans, of course, are welcome. You guys will always be welcome. Here it is. Let's look at the lyrics of Shake It Off by Taylor Swift. I have to warn you, this song is not easy. It sounds funny, it sounds happy, but it's a difficult song because it has a lot of slang. It is a song full of slang, guys. Just like Taylor Swift, Cruel Summer, one of the best songs we have done on Listen and Learn. This one, also not that easy. The first part is easy though. She says, I stay out too late, T-double-O, got nothing in my brain. Got nothing in my brain? What do you mean, got nothing in my brain? Does she have nothing in her brain because she stayed out too late? Or does she have nothing in her brain because she's just drunk? Oh, that's what people say when you stay out too late. Okay, that makes sense. She got nothing in her brain. That's what people say. She doesn't say it about herself. That's what other people say. Is it for B1? Just listen and find out. I go on too many dates. Anyone here got the same feeling? You go on too many dates. I go on too many dates. Not me. I only sit in my house and I come out once a week to throw out the trash. So not me, guys, not me. Or is every live stream a date with you guys? But I can't make them stay. There's your first, it's still quite straightforward. But I can't make them stay. Can't make who stay, guys? Can't make who stay? That's the question. I go on too many dates, but I can't make them stay. The guy she dated, exactly. At least that's what people say. At least that's what people say. She's using the word at least. I know many of you don't use the word at least, guys. At least, A-T-L-E-A-S-T-S. S-T, sorry. A-T-L-E-A-S-T. At least. At least that's what people say. What's the meaning of at least? When would you use the word at least? It is it helps you to make bigger sentences, definitely. At least kinda. Kinda is not the right, yeah, minimally. At least. If you try to make it more simple, minimally, but not in this case. Not in this case, minimum. No. Because in this case, she says, at least that's what people say. At least that's what people say. At least, in this case, it's like a counter. It's an opposite. It's an opposite. Like, she doesn't agree with it. At least that's what people say. It doesn't have to be that way. But people are saying it. That's what people say. Stop speaking Spanish and French. I'm an English teacher. Learn English with us. At least I stay in Learn with Lucas streaming twice a week. So close to being perfect. I like learning English. So at least I'll try to watch Lucas's live stream twice a week. But in this case, at least means minimally. And in Taylor Swift's song, it doesn't. All right, I'm going a little bit too fast. But I keep cruising, can't stop, won't stop moving. Cruising, C-R-U-I-S-I-N-G, cruising, just means like cruising in a car. You're just driving at not a very fast speed, but you're going, you're moving, you don't stop, you're cruising. But she won't stop moving. She doesn't stop moving. Sorry, I pressed these. You can press the like button if you like the song. My bad, I clicked the wrong one. It's like I got this music in my mind. So far, guys, people are saying these things about her. People are saying these things about her. And she says, but I keep cruising, can't stop, won't stop moving. She just keeps going. She just keeps doing what she does no matter what people say. Summary of the story. Summary of the story. It's like I got this music in my mind saying it's gonna be all right. Nice. It's good to have that in your brain, you know? Like, it's gonna be all right. Like the first song, the sun is coming back. Positive things in this case. It's gonna be all right. Now. She is moving on very fast. She is saying, cause the players gonna play, 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 play. And the haters gonna hate, 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 hate. Simply said, people do what they do. They do what they do. Cause the players gonna play. Cause instead of because. She doesn't say because the players gonna play. She says cause the players. This is okay in American English. You can say cause. So C-A-U-S-E. Cause the players gonna play. Players as in, yeah, like playboy, playgirl. The people who are always dating, you know, but never settling down. Maybe with more than one girlfriend. Cause the players gonna play and the haters gonna hate. The people telling her this, those are the haters. Those are the haters. You ever had a hater, guys? Did you ever had a hater bother you? They will say, your English is so bad, you should just quit. You should just stop. Hate is gonna hate, guys. Your English is gonna be all right. That's what Taylor Swift tells you. And her response to that is, baby, I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake it off. I shake it off. Obviously, just a nice slang, shake it off. She's not literally in the street shaking, okay, guys? She is not literally shaking. Shake it off just means let it go. Let it go. Someone says something bad about you. Whatever. Let it go. Pah. Shake it off like, you know, a cat or a dog shakes off the water so they are not wet anymore. Shake off those bad comments so you don't feel bad anymore. Don't take people too serious. You got it, okay? Shake it off. Heartbreakers gonna break, break, break. Fakers gonna fake, fake, fake. Guys, what is a faker? What is a faker, guys? F-A-K-E-R. What is a faker? People who pretend. Yes, pretentious people. Exactly. Like Taylor herself in a lot of ways, yes. But that's not the point right now. We are just listening to the song. My ex-mother-in-law. Nice. I'm just gonna shake, shake, shake it off. That's what you're supposed to do. Just shake it off. Faker, bad person. Doesn't sincerely have to be a bad person. It's just someone pretending to be someone who they are not. Maybe we have all done it at some point. It doesn't mean we're a bad person. Sometimes you fake to be someone for someone else. Like you want a relationship, you know, the girl is looking for a confident guy. On a fake to be confident. Pseudo person, yes. or if you're into League of Legends, Faker, the number one player in the world. All right. Here comes the slang. Here comes the slang. I never miss a beat. I never miss a beat. What do you think? I never miss a beat. Just means I just keep going. I don't let anything stop me. I never miss a beat. For example, I upload videos every day. I never miss a beat. Every single day you got a video. As long as I've been on TikTok, I have never skipped a day of videos. Never miss a beat. B-E-A-T. Got it? Good. And then she says, I'm lightning on my feet. I'm lightning on my feet. Just means you're fast. Lightning. Lightning on my feet. I'm fast. I just keep going. And that's what they don't see. They don't see that Taylor doesn't care. They don't see that she never skips a beat. She just keeps doing what she's doing. All right? She doesn't care about their, words. Lightning. You know? Lightning. Like Lightning McQueen from Disney's Cars. Lightning McQueen. Boring in capital letters. What is boring, my friend? Your spamming is quite boring, yes. I would be bored if I was your friend too. Ooh, that's what they don't know. All right, let's see. Let us see. And that's what they don't know. Listen, people will always judge you. Ka-chow. Yes, I love watching cars. Ka-chow. If you don't know what it means, don't worry. That's what they don't see and that's what they don't know. This is the important part. People will always be judging you, but they don't even know you. They don't even know you. What you have been through to get here, what you have been doing, you know, they don't even know who you are, really. It's like when you guys are saying, do you want to be my boyfriend? You don't even know me, bro. You don't even know me. And now she continues, but I keep cruising. She just keeps going. That's what she's saying. And we play the same part again. Orange juice time. Sorry, guys. Need some orange juice. That drink makes you handsome? Of course it does. You drink tea, you get better looking instantly. Especially if you drink water. All right. So she continues with the shaking off, shaking off, shaking off. Nice. And then she does a little second voice, little story on the background. Here it is. Here it is. I need to go a little bit back because she speaks very fast. Listen, guys, she speaks very fast. There it is. It is a very long sentence. Hey, just think, while you've been getting down and out about the liars and the dirty cheats of the world, you could have been getting down to this sick beat. That's the whole sentence. It's one sentence. Hey, just think, while you've been getting down and out out about the liars and the dirty cheats of the world, you could have been getting down to this sick beat. What she is saying, guys. What she is saying. While you've been getting down and out. While you've been getting down and out. You know, getting down can mean different things. You can say getting down. If somebody asks you if you want to practice your English speaking, you could say, I'm down. I'm down. Which means you're ready to do so. You can say, I'm down to speak English. Getting down and out, in this case, getting down and out just means focusing on it. Getting down can also mean getting sad, you know, getting so sad about something you are focusing on. So she says, hey, just think about this. Think about this for a second. While you've been getting down and out about these bad people, you know, you've been starting to feel bad because of these bad people and whatever, you could have been getting down to this sick beat, getting down to this sick beat just means you could start dancing and feel good about this beat. You can, you know, getting down to dancing in about a beat. So she's using a slang with two different meanings in the same sentence. Welcome to Intermediate English. A slang with two different meanings in the same sentence. Getting down could mean starting to feel sad, starting to feel depressed. Getting down also means like you're down to party, you're ready to go. You're going into this. And whatever. Getting down. All right. There's a second part to the story. Let's see what she says. My ex-man brought his new girlfriend. She's like, oh my God, I'm just... These sentences are even longer, guys. Let's just listen for a second. All right. Let's go back. We have a hella in here, guys. You learned hella 2 weeks ago. There's a hella in this song, which is great. All right. Listen, my ex-man brought his new girlfriend. She's like, oh my God, but I'm just gonna shake it. Like shaking it off. She's gonna ignore it. She's singing about it, so... Oh my God, I'm just gonna shake into the paradox. And then she says, and to the fella over there, fella, fella, F-E-L-L-A, fella. Comes from fellow, an old English word, F-E-L-L-O-W, fellow, which just means guy. Like, hey fellow, hey guy, she is saying fella. Fella, because she wants to rhyme it with hella. Fella and fellow, Dida is correct, yes. Fellow. Maybe in the 1950s, 1960s, you would say, hey, fellow, watch your tone. Watch your tone. Hey, fellow, watch your tone. But she's saying fella. She's saying, and to the fella over there with the hella good hair. Guys, I told you, what is the meaning of hella? H-E-L-L-A. Hella. Fella equals hella equals hello. No. I don't know what you mean by that. Fella means guy. Hella means like super, incredible, amazing, good hair. Yeah, more than a lot, Korean friend. More than a lot. Okay, Sion. Won't you come on over, baby? She is very straightforward. Won't you come on over, baby? We can shake, shake, shake. I'm not gonna explain that part to you. Let's go back to the first sentence one more time. My ex-man brought his new girlfriend, so took her with him. She's like, oh my god, I'm just gonna shake, ignore it, great. Fella hella. Good English, good English. All right.
Shake it off. I shake it off, I shake it off.
Let's just say she invited him to dance, yeah. She invited him to dance to shake it off. Absolutely. Can I give an example of hella? Your English is hella good. Means so good. You're hella awesome. Means you're incredibly awesome. Yes, and boys that don't know how to talk to girls would say, girl, you look hella fine. You look hella fine. Hella does not mean hello, guys. All right, this was Taylor Swift, Shake It Off. Can't believe we did another Taylor Swift song. Beside what you think about Taylor Swift, you can learn a few idiom slang from this song, which is always great. Cheers to improving your English every day, to learning for free together with all you amazing English learners. Thank you so much. This last song is a more modern song. With more modern, I mean, I think it's from last year. Out of my head. Oh, no, it's not last year. He did update last year. This song is from 2016. Enjoy the song. Mohammed, I can read your comments. I'm gonna turn off my Discord, especially because of you. Inside my bones, it goes electric, baby, when you turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we... You do nothing. You don't have to tell us, Mohammed, that you don't do anything. Because here we are learning English together. Don't worry, Empire, we got one more song to learn English from. It's alright, it's okay. Then you play Roblox all day. Enjoy your life, 9-year-old. Dance, dance, dance. This is Justin Timberlake. Can't stop the feeling. Justin Timberlake can't stop the feeling. Justin Timberlake can't stop the feeling. Justin Timberlake can't stop the feeling. Just dance, dance. We can do a live stream, especially for sad songs, okay? Lag? That's how it goes. With a mountain. If the internet is back, don't forget to like the live stream. Let's make it another beautiful 100,000 today. Thank you. We made it to spot 99 again in the TikTok live stream popularity list this week. Thank you so much. Spot number 99 because of you. Signal is intermittent. Yes. Welcome to China. As soon as I leave China, internet's gonna be so good, you don't even know. I'm gonna add the YouTube Beautiful Day also to the song playlist. And I'm going to add Justin Timberlake's Can't Stop This Feeling to my YouTube playlist. Go to English with Lucas on YouTube. You can find our whole playlist with over 100 songs to learn English from. Not my songs, of course. All right, this is Can't Stop This Feeling by Justin Timberlake. All right, I like it. I like it a lot. Let's do this as the last song for today. That's what we're gonna do, guys. Justin Timberlake, Can't Stop This Feeling will be the last song we will analyze today. Maybe not the last song we'll listen to. Here is a like and a cry. Tell me if you like this song or you do not. Do you like it? Does it make you feel good? Or not? Because it's Justin Timberlake, some people don't like it. That's okay. It's okay to be different. I like it, it's a happy song. I don't listen to it when I'm alone, but that's okay. You're trying to annoy me? Congratulations, you are muted again. Everybody say bye, Mohammed. Muted entire live stream. If you admit to trying to annoy me, there you go. See you next live stream, Mohammed. It has a few different things in it, a few slang terms in the song that you can learn from, but in general, just a good song to listen to. So let's do it. I got this feeling inside my bones. Yes, guys, you know when you get that feeling inside your bones? People say this. When you get the feeling inside your bones, deep inside of you, ooh, feel good, or it can feel bad. Like when you think there is a ghost behind you, you got that feeling in your bones, you start tingling. Okay, feeling in your bones. A very deep feeling, yes, a very strong feeling. It goes electric, wavy, when I turn it on. He turns the feeling on. That's nice if you can turn on those feelings. All through my city, all through my home. He is turning on the feeling everywhere he is. We're flying up, no ceiling, when we're in our zone. This is an important one. Zone, guys. Zone. When we're in the zone. This is a popular English slang. When you're in the zone, normally means when you're really focused. Like if I'm saying I'm in the zone right now, means I'm really focused on something. But in this case, when we're in our zone,
It just means, you know, the comfortable community they're in, the comfortable people they're with, our zone. It's like the comfort zone. The things you are comfortable with. All right. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. Got that sunshine in my pocket. He got that sunshine, that good feeling close to him in his pocket. Next to his hips, you know, next to his hips. B, welcome back. Long time no see. And he got that good soul in his feet. Soul, as in soul music. S-O-U-L, soul. And I got that good soul in my feet. Yes, he got that good soul. Pun, camera guy. I think it's a pun indeed. Pun intended. And he got that good soul in his feet, like dancing, like dancing. He got that good soul in his feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. I can't take my eyes up off it. Ooh, interesting combination of words. I can't take my eyes up off it. Up off it. Good English sentence, because you can say eyes up, but he can't take his eyes up off it. Confusing, but good. Off with double F. Off, like on and off. 100,000 likes. Thank you so much for your support today. Because of those likes and your gift supporting free English every day, we are back to number 99 on the TikTok popularity live streams. Don't know how, don't know why, but thank you. Room unlock, the way we rock it. So don't stop. Interesting. Room unlock. Room unlock, which means locked down. The door is locked. Room unlock, the way we rock it. The way we rock it. R-O-C-K, like rock music. You can also rock it. Means being very good at something. Or just, you know, enjoying. Like, you are rocking those shoes. Means it looks amazing on you. But you can also rock music. So, enjoying the music. Rock it. Not rocket, guys. Rock it. Two words. R-O-C-K-I-T. When we rock it, so don't stop. Under the lights when everything goes. Under the lights when everything goes. Nowhere to hide. Yes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. This is starting to sound intense. This is starting to sound intense. Nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. Ooh! When we move, well, you already know. When we move in dancing, we are talking about dancing. When we move, well, you already know. Just imagine, just imagine, just imagine. I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. You all right. Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. That's a good compliment. Sorry. When this is for the guys, when a girl asks you, hey, do you see that girl? You say, I can't see anyone but you. Because you are hella fine. All right. Feeling good. creeping up on you. Ooh, creeping up on you. Creeping up on you. Creeping up. Creeping up, normally used as like scared feelings. Are they creeping up on you? Ooh, but this is good creeping, okay? The feeling of good creeping up on you. You're starting to feel better and better and better. Yeah, you're feeling good. So just dance, all right? You're feeling good. So just learn English, all right? Hey, you're welcome to the live stream. So just follow for free English videos, all right? Otherwise, Lucas will be creeping up on you. Lucas will be creeping up on you. I will not be the only one creeping up on you if you don't learn English with us. You better come here to learn English with us. Okay, anyway. All those things that I shouldn't do. Yeah, we all do things that we shouldn't be doing. Lucas will be at your window at 3 a.m. if you skipped his class. Yes, exactly. Why didn't you watch my live stream? You could have learned free English, but you didn't. Why, huh? You were playing Roblox again, huh? You were watching Cocomelon again, huh? I knew it! Ain't nobody leaving soon, so just keep dancing. In this case, you can use ain't. Remember last week, they were using ain't wrong, in wrong grammar. In this case, you can say ain't nobody leaving. It's a good English sentence. Ain't. A-I-N apostrophe T. Ain't nobody dancing. Ain't nobody leaving soon, so just keep dancing, all right? So just keep dancing. Everybody's here. Everybody's learning English. So just keep learning English with us. I should make a parody of this song. I get a song idea about learning English with us. I should take this song and make it about English learning, okay? I'm gonna write down that idea. Guys, I get a random idea at random moments. Normally when I'm on the toilet, but this is a better situation. English learning parody. There you go. Wrote it down, so I don't forget. It's something magical. It's something magical, you know? It's something magical. It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. Ooh, what feeling? That feeling is magical. The feeling of happiness, the feeling of keep going, you know, it just feels magical. I'm not gonna unmute Mohammed. He can come back the next live stream and talk again. This live stream, he is muted. What ain't stand for? What does ain't stand for, guys? A-I-N apostrophe T. What does ain't stand for? Tell me. I'm Mohammed. Well, you better behave, otherwise this account will also be muted. Cause I don't have the time for you. Isn't, yes. Isn't or am not, depending on the context, depending on the sentence. I'm in the University of Geoscience, Wuhan. You are very close, yes. I'm in Wuhan, close to Nanhu. Good job. It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. Oxygen? Is he talking about oxygen? O2? Let's talk about a feeling. Don't need no reason, don't need control. I fly so high, no ceiling. When I'm in my zone. So now we know that his zone is when he has the feeling of dancing, you know, having a good time. That's the zone he is talking about. And he's saying, I'm flying so high, no ceiling. Like, he is super happy, really ecstatic. Ecstatic, you know, he's feeling great. Because he got that sunshine in his pocket. He feels that hot blood in his body. And now we're just repeating the same text we had before, so just enjoy. Just enjoy. Lucas's only dance move in the bar is this. This is me in a bar. When I was 18, this was the only thing I would do when I go out. Yes, guys. You gotta know what you're good at, okay? Singing? No. Dancing? No. English teaching? Maybe. Every night, 8 p.m., a live stream. Good song and good DJ. That's it. Account is your butter. Thank you. You're spamming again. The next sentence you spam, and this account will be muted too. I know you are excited, and I know you are bored of playing Roblox, but spamming somebody on the internet is not the right answer, my friend. Enjoying this song? That's the right answer, so just enjoy the song, alright? What's up, Teddy Bear? Welcome back. Good to see you again. You see that? Number 99! Welcome back. Keep liking, guys. That's how we become the top 100 on TikTok. Believe it or not, TikTok says it. I don't, okay? I'm glad you are here. We are the number 99 on TikTok. New account and huh? New account just got muted. Congratulations. The next account, Mohammed, will get banned. He's gone. What a nice song! Justin Timberlake, Can't Stop This Feeling. Yes, Can't Stop This Feeling. I like it a lot. It's a happy song, right? I added it to my YouTube playlist, so if you go to English with Lucas on YouTube, you can find this song and enjoy it too. Thank you so much, everybody, for being here. I appreciate you so much. Today we have done three amazing songs about feeling happy. That's why I'm feeling so good right now. I'm also feeling good because I'm gonna eat some more food. Thank you so much for being here today. I am going to say goodnight because it is 11 p.m. in China right now. Welcome tomorrow, 3 hours earlier. Tomorrow, English Challenge Day. Maybe your favorite. Tomorrow, English Challenge Day. We're gonna do three challenges to improve your vocabulary or grammar or both and see who can be in the top 10. So thank you for being here. See you tomorrow. Have a good night. And I like you. I like you a lot. See you around.